Hey guys, how's it going? It's Winter, and I'm joined today with Aegis. We're doing something a little funky. I think you have all probably heard of the YouTuber CORPSE. I have most definitely heard of the YouTuber CORPSE. I used to listen to his horror videos all the time. As I've told you before, Aegis and anyone who's listening, I'm a huge horror buff. So I'm not going to claim I was the biggest fan of this guy, but I certainly knew his work, and I enjoyed him. And I stumbled across him probably 6 months ago now, playing Among Us with PewDiePie. And that led to me discovering that he had started doing music. Aegis, I know I shoved E-Girls Are Ruining My Life down your throat when I first found it. I think you were a little surprised by the song, but you were entertained by it, weren't you?
Oh, that's funny. You shoved E-Girls down my throat, but usually it's the reverse, right?
Right. Oh, God. Oh, okay. Well, all right. Well, with that note, I'm going to show you a song today that's just as shocking as E-Girls. We're going to take a reaction to Daywalker, which is the new song that CORPSE has done with MGK. Now, we all know MGK. You can have mixed feelings about his actions towards Eminem. You can have mixed feelings towards his reactions of making more punk rock style music with Tickets to My Downfall. But I think he's made a right move here. MGK has embraced the internet age, and he's taken a relatively famous YouTuber who's up and coming, and he's made what I consider to be a good rap. Now, for everyone who's listening, I've already heard this song. I checked it out as soon as it came out last night. I heard it within 15 minutes of it coming out. I found the first leaked video on YouTube. Aegis, though, I told Aegis to hold back, and we're going to have an honest first reaction from Aegis. Aegis, do you know what daywalkers are?
Well, being a ginger, I know full well, or at least extrapolate what they are. But I'm going to assume it's not ginger, just because the floor has blood in the video.
Yeah, so no, I mean, ginger's a pretty good guess. Daywalker is a vampire that can walk in the daylight. Probably the most famous example being Blade from the Blade comics. Basically, it means that they still have a little bit of their soul left, which means that they can hide amongst humans much more easily than other vampires. So I'll tell you right now, the song isn't about vampires, but I do love the aesthetic the choice of the name gave it. And I think you'll appreciate that too once you've heard the song. So without further ado, yeah, we'll see. I mean, this might not be your style of music, but we thought we'd try something out. So without further ado, I know you've got the song and the lyrics up on your computer. I can't see it, just so everyone knows, but we're just going to kick it off, and Aegis is going to pause whenever he feels like it, and we're going to discuss it.
Okay, I'm going to start playing it right now.
That motherfucker in the face. You hated what he said, right? Beat his ass, leave him at the stoplight. I know you want to change, but nobody's around, so kick him again while he's on the ground. Y'all never be the same. I want to know if I tell you a secret, will you keep it? I need someone to blame. And I see somebody talking with a mouth that's full of teeth I want to break. Fright, 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 fright.
Okay, so I just paused where CORPSE came in there. Winter?
Alright, so you are at the fight, fight, fight part?
Yeah, he just finished up the chorus.
It's not a chorus, but, I mean, it's not a chorus, meaning it's just one word over and over again. What do you think?
I like the video. I like some of MGK's shit, but I got an emo vibe from part of it, but like old school, like MCR kind of feel, but also like it's like a rap spin on it, but I'm not sure how I feel about it. I think I'm just kind of like guided by just my, I guess, mixed feelings about MGK, just because I don't really listen to a lot of him, but I know about his interactions with Eminem, and just, I think he did a cover of a Rise Against song years ago. Was it Prayer of the Refugee or something?
Yeah, he's done a few covers. I heard that he did Killing in the Name of at 1.2, which I need to check out.
Yeah, that could be a good cover. But, I mean, it's okay. I probably wouldn't go out of my way to listen to this part, but I think I just heard the first little snippet of CORPSE. So I think that's where it's going to get fun.
Well, I would say when I first heard MGK's side, this track, it feels like it fits CORPSE better. That really menacing aesthetic. Wow, that was hard to spit out. Menacing, yep. Menacing aesthetic. Wow. All right. Well, everyone knows what I'm trying to say. Menacing aesthetic. But I think MGK, considering it seems that he's stepping more into CORPSE's ring to make him comfortable, I think he did a good job off the kick. It's a very aggressive, very in-your-face intro to the song. I enjoyed it. But all right, well, let's get into the CORPSE.
I guess they also could have. He also could have said fight a little more, less bitchy.
I mean, I think, yeah, again, I think that comes down to he doesn't have that really deep voice that
no.
when you're thinking like hyping up someone in an angry way. Hear CORPSE's version. Start it back up and tell me what you think.
Okay. Also, on that note, I would have a hard time believing CORPSE's voice is real and not edited.
It's absolutely real. He is GERD.
Okay, then I'm gonna listen to this guy, girl.
So basically, what happens with CORPSE is he started off, his voice was really deep back in his older videos.
Yep.
But he got GERD, and it's gotten more gravelly. So okay. It's not modified. When he speaks on Among Us and stuff, that actually is his real voice. Now, this is his rapping voice, so it flows a little differently. But no, the gravel and the deepness, it's real. And the screaming in the background that you hear during every other part is also him. He's doing the screamo parts, too.
Okay, that's cool. Then I'm excited to listen to it then.
All right, so I'll quiet down then.
Thank God. Fight! 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 Yeah. They tried to kill me in the rain. Tried to let me down, so I ducked and ran away. Put a gun up to my face. I'll fucking catch a case. When I find this motherfucker, then I lay on his grave. All these fucking rays of lights. I wanna know if I tell you a secret, will you keep it? I won't ever be the same. I bit the fucking apple, I'm surrounded by some snakes. Fight! Dude, CORPSE's part was sick. Wow.
Yeah, right? His voice fits the... And that's why I'm not taking a shot at MGK over this. His voice just fits the tone better, right?
That's just like the backtrack exactly fits like the menacing voice that he has.
So what do you think of the lyrics? I mean, when I heard this, the first thing I saw was both of them seem to be talking about actual things that probably happened in their life. I love the visual statement of I bit the effing apple, I'm surrounded by snakes. Like the tie-in to the devil trying to make you do evil things. I really enjoyed just how menacing and aggressive this opening was.
Yeah, I find when I first listen to a song, I'm not like trying to like do a dive into like the meaning behind the lyrics. I'm also just, it's mainly like I'm listening to like the groove of the voice and the video if there's a video. And
right.
Like, just how the words flow together, how they feel. Like,
no, that's fair.
Like, when so they tried to kill me in the rain, tried to lay me down, so I ducked and ran away, put a gun up to my face so I'll fucking catch a case. When I find this motherfucker, I'll lay in this grave. So, I mean, do you know if this has happened? Like, something that he's alluding to something in this song?
What I know is that from what I've heard from CORPSE's live streams, and I've actually, I backed into one of his live streams. I came in late, but I do watch them sometimes. He talked about how this song was personal to him. He didn't 100% confirm it was factual, but he basically said him and MGK had the choice to either make a pop song or they had a choice to make a personal song, and they went with this. And at the same time, the repeated thing within the song is, if I tell you a secret, will you keep it? Which to me really implies this song is based on real life, and they're basically implying, is it safe to tell people this?
Or I guess something happened where like they told somebody like something that was secret, and then they let it out, and then maybe they both got beat the fuck up or something.
Right, so you don't know, and I mean, to me it's just like, this is fight music. If I was going to get into a fight, I'd probably want this in the background.
This is like you're walking up to the ring, and like, you know, this is like the music going on.
Yeah, take it up to the boxing ring. Well, we're learning. Everyone in the crowd, we are learning how to box. I would usually
fight,
play metal.
But... Fight, fight.
Well, I usually play metal, but to me, this works. I would absolutely play this at boxing. I would see no reason why I wouldn't. But let's get you into verse 3 here, because verse 3 is quite entertaining.
Okay. All right. Clicking it now. Okay, that last verse, I don't know how it got better than verse 2, but it did. Holy shit.
I think they played off each other very well in the last verse. CORPSE doing the, I'm going to call it emo core metal screams in the background to MGK's lighter voice.
Yep.
Did you notice that? Like, CORPSE was basically screaming the last lines of each line that MGK said.
Yep.
I think that worked perfectly for their voices.
Also, is it mumble rap? Is that what's called mumble rap? Or they're just called really speed rap or whatever the fuck it is?
The very end of it? Yeah, I don't know if you'd call that mumble rap or whisper rap. It reminds me of like some music that we would have heard in like junior high dances, but I forget what the group was called. No, seriously. I mean, but in a good way. Like, this is much more aggressive than I remember, but a fast, almost whispery rap reminds me of something that I can't put my finger on.
Thank God. I thought you meant by lips of an angel, something like that kind of thing. No.
No, that's not what I meant. What do you think overall of the song?
Going into it, I didn't care for it. It got better. Right. It got awesome. And I kind of just want to click replay again and go work out.
Yeah, I agree. The visuals in the last part, MGK saying that, like, he prays to God, but then when he goes to bed, he has bloody hands. And then CORPSE saying that, I didn't mean to laugh at this. It's pretty dark, but it's pretty intense. Me and these pills are on a first name basis. There's an invisible voice that's talking to me. And it's always telling me to kill. I've got problems with separating what my head is creating from the things that are real. I'm in a room hyperventilating and debating to pop the caps off these pills. Like, those lines are intense.
Yeah, that's not like, that seems like it's pretty real, largely inspired by something that happened to him or them. The last line, if I get angry, I'm going to step right like people on Capitol Hill. Yeah, also, oof.
That yeah, that was timely. Yeah. I don't know. I don't know if in music it's a good idea to directly reference something that's tied in with a time frame. But I feel like those events are going to go down in history and people are going to know about them for a long time.
I mean, music doesn't do that, right? It never does that.
Yeah, no, that's fair. So what do you think overall?
I want a quick replay, but around like the minute mark. Actually, it's not a minute because I think MGK only goes for like 30 seconds. I think I need to listen to it again just to give MGK a second chance instead of just like prejudging him and letting that kind of guide myself.
All right, well, while I appreciate that, I think we had agreed you're going to try Catgirls Are Ruining My Life, which means we don't have time for you to hit replay. But I would say yes. Knowing that MGK is building into the later verses and it's meant to get more and more intense,
yep.
I would say give it another go, understanding that now, right?
Totally.
All right, let's do a quick cut here, and then let's check out Catgirls Are Ruining My Life, because you've already heard E-Girls.
True. Are we going to... Let's just call it there then.
Yeah, let's quick cut.
Okay, cool beans.